Herbert Hainer became CEO of sports giant Adidas in 2001. What defines his leadership style?
I definitely do believe that heritage is a quite important thing, because I think this defines our route where we are going. Just a few months ago, we have relaunched the so-called Adidas standards here in our company. And we try to educate everybody who is in the company to go the way how Adidasler did it, what he really meant when he spoke to athletes, when he brought in new products, when he brought in innovative products, try to permanently improve the products for the best of the athlete. And this is what is our heritage, but also our future. When I took over as CEO beginning of 2001, we had already great success story behind us. You might remember we went to the stock market in 1995, and then we had 4 or 5 good years. But then we came a little bit too self-complacent, a little bit too self-confident. We were not aggressive anymore. The processes were not harmonized anymore. Our lack of innovation was shining through. So my job was not to revolutionize the company again. We had very good pillars for our company, but my job was to make the whole ship much faster and make out of a big tanker speedboats again. And this is what we did at that time. You are what you are. And of course, if I run the company, then I want to have people around me who are as I am. I want to have people who are fast, who are direct, who are aggressive. And therefore, you create a culture with you and your people around, because they want to have people around themselves which are in the same style. And I definitely do believe that we are today much faster, much more proactive, how we cater to the market, how we talk to our consumers, how we bring products and concepts to market, how fast we can react to certain trends in the market. And I think this is what it is all about, that you become faster. Not the size is a decisive factor, in my opinion, because otherwise the dinosaurio still would be alive and all the little animals would be dead. It is the fastest one who will win the race. I mean, in general, it starts with the people which you put in charge. I do remember going back to 2000 when I formulated the new agenda for Adidas. We had around 30 people who were working in R&D. And there were two hierarchy levels in between until they come to the board member. What we did at that time, simply, we took out the R&D department and let them directly report to the board member of marketing, so that they go to the highest level. This, on the other hand, also showed the importance which we gave to the R&D department within the organization. The second point was that within the next 12 months, we doubled the number of people in R&D. We put much more money into it, and then we put two different locations for R&D. One here in Herzog, where we more or less put all the European sports categories under the R&D umbrella, and then one R&D umbrella in America for the more American sports, which is basketball or outdoor sport or some others. The CEO will always be seen from his employee how things should be done in the company. So you are always a role model, whether you like it or you dislike it. But people look to you, and whatever you do, good or bad, they will follow. This means if you, for example, talk permanently about sport and that people should be active and you don't do any sport, then they will see it and they will not believe you at the end of the day. And this goes through whatever you do. So there is a saying in Germany, the fish always stinks from the head. And I think this is the most important thing, that you live what you make your employees believe and what you make them doing. You should be the role model for them. And if you do that, the people will relatively fast realize that you are honest, you say what you are, or you do what you are saying, and then you also get their opinion, because they know they don't have to fear any restrictions if they tell you what they think. And you go out, I do sport with our people, we play football together, or we run together, and this gives them a feeling that, yeah, I'm one of them, and they can tell me what's going on in the company.